It's unfair.
We would be honored if you would join us.
Hey guys, so here is the second concept art image from my live-action Darth Vader fan film. So who can guess the familiar Jedi in the scene? I have about 11 or more for you on the way, with the next 10 being lower resolution art, and the last being my favorite, which is the biggest scene in the fan film itself that will make the movie what it is. It's a scene that I wrote, and I can't wait to bring it to life in real acting for you. I'll release them almost daily as the fundraiser drops over this month. Let's get on with today's video, shall we? So, there are tons of force powers. Just Google them for yourself if you want. The list is literally endless, especially in Legends. But which one was the most powerful? The most useful, should I say? It was one that we've seen in the movies, however, it was never talked about. It's not really something many except for the diehard fans know about. Shout out to you all that are watching. You know who you are. The power isn't some crazy ability to stop ships in midair or to cheat death itself, which are all cool, but rather this one comes to those who practice with Force knowledge. This ability is one that fully grown Jedi Masters merely grasped a concept of, if they even did. It was one that was given to someone I believe could have been the Chosen One, had the prophecy believed he were the divine entity. This power was called Shatterpoint, and it was mastered by Mace Windu. Did you ever wonder how Mace was the only Jedi in history to defeat Darth Sidious? Something even Yoda couldn't do? Now, I believed Palpatine threw the fight so that, you know, he could set it up for Anakin's arrival. However, after George Lucas literally stated in the commentary of Episode 3 that Mace fully beat him fair and square, I became a believer that Mace has extreme powers. He was, after all, trained by Master Yoda as well. So what is Shatterpoint? Now, in the Legends novel Shatterpoint by Matthew Stover, we're given the most perfect explanation of what the power is through Mace Windu's explanation himself. Here we go. I can see Shatterpoints. The sense is not sight, but see is the closest word Basic has for it. It is a perception, a feel of how what I look upon fits into the Force, and how the Force binds it to itself and to everything else. I was 6 or 7 standard years old, well into my training in the Jedi Temple, before I realized that other students, full-grown Jedi Knights, even wise masters, could sense such connections only with difficulty, and only with concentration and practice. The Force shows me strengths and weaknesses, hidden flaws and unexpected uses. It shows me vectors of stress that squeeze or stretch, torque or shear. It shows me how patterns of these vectors intersect to form the matrix of reality. Put simply, when I look at you through the Force, I can see where you break. I looked at Jango Fett on the sand in the Genosian arena. A perfect combination of weapons, skills, and the will to use them. An interlocking crystal of killer. The Force hinted a Shatterpoint, and I left a headless corpse on the sand. The deadliest man in the galaxy. Now, just dead. Situations have Shatterpoints, like gems. But those of situations are fluid, ephemeral, appearing for a bare instant, vanishing again to leave no trace of their existence. They are always a function of timing. There is no such thing as a second chance. When I next encounter Dooku, he will be the war's Shatterpoint no longer. I can't stop this war with a single death. But on that day, in the Genosian arena, I could have. This explanation was the best one that I could find, as it comes from Master Windu himself about his own technique. Now, why is this the most powerful? Well, not in the traditional sense where someone could, you know, force push or crush an object, for example, but because this ability allowed Mace Windu to be the only person in the galaxy to defeat Darth Sidious, something even Yoda couldn't do himself, nor Vader. So how this power worked, essentially, was basically like looking at the world and everyone in it as if they were made of Jenga. Yeah, pretty much, that's the best way I can explain it. Mace would be able to see which point was the most vulnerable to bring the person down, and he'd strike there. Sometimes that window was only available in a quick passing moment, like when he fought Palpatine, but nevertheless, it was there, and that's how he was the most powerful. Now, what could be his downfall? If he turned to the dark side, or used more of the dark side than he already did to make that lightsaber purple, as it was, then he would have a hard time using his lightsaber form, Vipod, which harnessed the opponent's dark side energy. But as far as Shatterpoint goes, he could literally see the world, so to speak, like broken shards of glass, or in other terms, like Jenga blocks, which is how he killed Jango Fett, the notorious Jedi killer. This is something many Jedi Masters wished to have mastered, but Unfortunately, they didn't. Only Mace Windu was born with the technique. I hope you guys enjoyed this video about Mace's powers, and I hope you enjoyed the second piece of concept art. I've got about 11 or more to show you this month with the fundraiser that drops. So thank you for watching today's episode. Let me know what you thought of Mace's powers and what other Force powers you think are the most powerful, or maybe your favorite. So until the next episode of Star Wars Theory, remember, my fellow Jedi and Sith friends,
the Force will be with you always.
Fulfill your destiny.